Spurs! Oh my god, it's Spurs! I love Spurs! Hey, what is up, guys? My name is King Kong Nam John, and today we're going to be playing If it wasn't relevant by the title of the video. Yeah. So yeah, this is a video game that's based on a solar system outside of our own. And you're an astronaut trying to mine the planet or other planets, if there are any other ones. Wink, wink. To get certain resources to trade and continue living and strike it rich, and yeah. And at the beginning, in the homepage or the start menu, you have an option to, launch a new guy. And oh my gosh, there's a little floaty thingy. Look, the mouse has a little orbital type thingy. It's like a little, solar panel or solar thingy. It's like a moon. There's a correct term for it. It's a satellite that orbits around it, if you like, circle around. Anyways, that's a tangent. I'm getting off topic. Today we are going to be continuing my game. I wanted to play this game a little bit, maybe 5 minutes to get the controls down, but I've spent 35 hours on this game. I got addicted to it, and I think I know why, but I'll get to that at the end of the episode. But today's episode, we are going to be focused on where I started and where I am now at the video game. And I wanted to bring y'all along with me, so let's get it. And the load times are extremely long, so pardon me for the loading time. This is a pre-alpha, so it's not the full-fledged game. So, yeah, you can actually buy it right now, but it's the pre-alpha. It's not the full thing right now. So, yeah. Let's get it. I love this soundtrack. All right, here we are. This is my first base I built. This is where I crash landed the first game, and yeah, this is my first base right here. I gotta remember which thingy I built first. I'm pretty sure I built this module right here first. It's called a research module. You take little blobs. Like this thing right here, you can grab it over in the foreground and pull it into here and do research on it. And actually, let me show you. Hold on. Let me stop talking about it and actually show y'all what it looks like in my little rover here. His name's Rover. Rover! Come here! Rover! Let's go. We're going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship, zooming through the sky. Alright, here's the little blob that I was talking about. Hopefully there's not a cavern. Oh, there's a cave. Gotta look out for those caves. Don't want to fall in just yet. What you do is you get out of your rover, you look up, and you grab it. And you grab it with all your might. If it's too high, like it is right now, take your little doodad here, and you make yourself go higher. Get yourself taller like me, and you grab it. It says unknown. You put it on your little rover, you climb down, and you get hurt, but then you jump into your rover, and you head back to the base. I'll see you there. Alright, now that we're back at the base, you take your, first let's connect our rover so that we can get more, go away. I'll show you next. So that we can get more battery right here and we can go longer distances. We take our unknown object and we put it in the researcher. And we press this itty bitty button to research that, not you, go away. To research it and see what's inside it. In this case, I got some, titanium. Oh, titanium's awesome. It's one of the most rare elements on this planet. It's really hard to find it. Which leads me to the next thing is, if you find some titanium, you can go to this, or you can make this little doohickey tray platform, and go into your packages, put this titanium in here, and you can get other things for it. You can trade titanium for compound, which is another element on here. You can get some lithium to make batteries and other things. Which brings me to the next module, which is this 3D printer, where you can make all kinds of things like solar panels, wind turbines, drill heads to drill farther underground, and a battery, which you can use the lithium for to store energy, like what I have over here. It's a big battery over here, and then I have a smaller battery on my pack so that I can drill more, which is awesome because, you know, you want to have a lot of energy or electricity so that you can keep on drilling down into the ground to get more resources. Which leads me to this next one, and it's called the smelly tin. Oh, the sun's up! Oh, batteries! I mean, the solar panels notice that there's sunlight, so, you know, they're starting to juice up everything and, you know, add more power to everything else. Now, a smelter, you can put iron ore in here and then melt it down so that you can actually use it with other, you know, machines and whatnot. Because when you find it in the earth, it's usually an iron ore, and you have to melt the ore to make the iron out of it, or the copper. Which brings me to the next thingy, which is this vehicle bay. You can design vehicles here, if my spaceship wasn't here. You can design other ships, like the spaceship, the shuttle. You can make a truck, which is way bigger than this rover I have over there. And you can make a rover, which is over there, way smaller. And you can add on things like, you can add on, like, you know, seats that can be more people in there, or a crane like I did over here, put a crane on there, or put storage on there as well. And that about sums up, you know, how to build a base. I didn't know it when I first got here, but how I built my base, it kind of leaves some room for improvement. I'm not able to expand more out past the five, you know, initial thingies that I have right here. Which brings me to base 2.0. Let me guess up my vehicle before we go, though. I want to make sure we have plenty of fuel to get over there. Goodbye, base! Actually, hold on. I want to show you what I've explored first. Underground. And I'm loving this sunshine. Oh my gosh. I love this sunshine. Some planets in this game only get like 14 minutes of sunshine and it's really dark. But the resources on those planets are magnifique. Cherry on top. I do have to say that the frame rates are really slow for my computer. My computer can handle like 60 frame 4K no problem. It's just the developers for this game hasn't really worked out the kinks for anything and everything for this game just yet. And oh my gosh, we're gonna fall. Like for me, the laws of gravity don't really apply that well. Just gonna get out here. Go down into this unknown cavern. I don't think it was this one, though. Was it this one? I can't can't remember. It was not this one. It's gotta be this one. Yeah, like, down here you can find these little unknown little thingies, and you can do research to find, you know, other elements that you can't probably find regularly underground or on the surface. Come on. So, we'll just explore. Let me get my bearings. Don't want to get lost here forever again. It's really easy to get lost underneath the surface because there's no stars to guide you at first, because I was dumb and didn't use these tether thingies everywhere. And yeah. Alright, so I'm going to go over to the cave system, which I explored previously, and I'll meet you there. Ah! Alright guys, here's the first tunnel system I've explored, and over here I see some copper ore. Let's go and collect some right here real fast. This copper ore looks like a triangle, like a star right now, but when you smelt it in the smelter up there, it'll be in kind of like a rectangular brick based thingy. And yeah, there's plenty of stuff to explore down here. These blue blobs are oxygen molecules, which you can suck vacuum up, and it'll give you more oxygen so that I can explore the caverns more underneath the ground. So let's head back to the base and head to the other bases that I have on the other planets. Yeah! Oh my god. Alright, we're back to the base and my rover just ran out of energy. That was one of the main, you know, reasons why I wanted a better base so that I can, you know, produce more energy and keep more energy in these batteries and have more places put the batteries. So that's why we built our second base. No, don't need that. Alright, off to base number dos. In a way! Squaw! Oh, this is the copper I was talking about. How it looks. It's all cubical. Not to be confused with cuticle. There's base two. This is the view of the planet that we're on. This enables us to select where we want to explore next. And stuff. You're able to see where the sun is on the planet and really, you know, zoom in to see where's the best possible next place to put your next base. Which for me, my next base was, if the planet could spin a little faster, it was right directly next to my original base. Eventually, I would like to make a bridge connecting these two bases. But yeah, let's strike Earth to the base 2.0 and show y'all a little bit of it. So yeah. Here's my second base. As you see, we did a lot of work, you know, getting everything, you know, put together. You know, just stuff, you know. But here's the truck I was talking about. This sucker is twice, its range is like twice as far as the shuttle. There's my old shuttle. Oh my gosh, I remember using that sucker every day until I found out the blueprints for the big old truck right here. But yeah, this sucker can hold a lot more storage. It goes a lot farther. And yeah, let me show you my second base. Yeah, come on. Oh my god! Okay. I wanted to make sure that the base head was, like, you know, in a, you know, nice level spot, but I did not get that. It's a little uneven. The good thing of this base area is it's right next to a cave system, which gives me easy access to, you know, minerals and, you know, supplies that I can reach easily. So what I started to do was collect resin to build these little thingies, you know, out sprawls of my base. And I decided to make this half and that half, you know, so that I don't have to, you know, have a whole little five triad or pentagram of, you know, stuff. But I can expand my base so that I can get more things to put on it, like batteries, solar panels that I can charge everything up, which leads me to this big monstrosity over here. This is a solar panel from hello, Edward. Tiffany the truck, you are Tiffany the truck, back of the truck thingy. But this originally was located over yonder, over there. I was able to use a winch, this little thingy right here, and put it on my truck. We'll just put it on my rover for now, just for purposes, and select the winch and put it on here, and I could drive it and drag it along with me. But if I no, and yeah, yep, whoop, stay right there. So I used the solar panel at first to add energy to my base. I was able to do it with linking several rovers up together so that it connects to the solar panel and to my base. And yeah. See, this is my base. Still exploring, you know. Blase. All stuff. Yeah. Here's my first shuttle that I crafted. I actually made this shuttle over at my first base, and then I built a vehicle bay to build my trucks and my rovers, and then I built another vehicle bay so that I can make a bigger spaceship rather than a shuttle. So right here you have the rover, you have the truck, and you have the shuttle, and then you have my spaceship. And right now we are experiencing a sandstorm, which will kill me dead if I do not go inside. Because apparently bricks of sand are deadly on this planet. Now there they go. What surprises me is that this sandstorm doesn't knock out, you know, any of my system, knock off any of my batteries while it's blowing. The good thing about, you know, being in this mother, you know, home pod habitat is I can manipulate my base from it without, you know, being outside. And it's a pretty decent range. I can manipulate anything on my base practically. If I was dumb and didn't pick that up and put it back, lovely, but progression, blah. Yeah, and it looks like the storm has subsided, so we can just get out of our habitat and freaking put my fuel container back over here. Shrink. I also wanted to make storage containers that, you know, are dictated by certain elements that I find on the planet. Like for instance, these storage containers are for fuel, and I made a fuel canister next to the vehicle base so that I can add fuel into my spaceship quicker and easily. But I have to keep things orderly, you know, so that, you know, they look top notch, because I like top notch material. Jesus! I'm gonna let that refuel and show you one of the cave systems that I've explored on this planet. The fuel condenser generates fuel out of electricity or energy, and then I can use that fuel to power up my space station, which apparently there's not enough fuel in. Gravity's pretty light over here, apparently. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. What have I done? Ah! Alrighty then. Just put you right there. Tally-ho? Question mark? Question mark. Question mark. Alright, let's get over to those caves right here. Explore. Again. For the first time for you, but the 57th time for me. But yeah. I learned that if you want to play this game, using tethers, creating tethers, is really, it just helps a lot. You can go farther with practically nothing to lose. Oh my god. Oh no, 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 no! Oh no. Oh my god. Ah. In all the times I played this game, I've never fallen off this ramp. I've never fallen off this ramp. Oh my gosh. Come on. Come on. Come on! Come on! Ah! Oh my gosh. Come on, you can do it. Come on, do it. These trucks are pretty strong. They have a lot of horsepower underneath them, you know. And yep. Horsepower. I found something very interesting down here while I was excavating the caves, and I was able to manage to get my truck down here to excavate it more. And thus, I found a telescope, if that makes any kind of sense. But, found a telescope down here. Yeah. And supposedly, if we were to power it up, we would get something in return. So let's put my battery in here. And there's nothing. Okay. But, there's other telescopes hidden around in the other planets, but apparently this one doesn't have anything inside it. If I'm correct, there shouldn't be anything inside it. Last time I checked, there is static inside it. There's transmissions being sent out of it. Yeah, there's nothing inside it just yet. But we will find another telescope and we can see whatever is inside it. Can I peek inside? No, I can't. Ugh. Can I? No, I can't. No, I can't. Oh, wait, hold on. I think I saw something. Alright. Let's get the flock out of Doge. Ah! Yeah, here's the telescope of awesomeness, of mystery, of secrets. Either one will work. Alright, let's check out my base again and head over to my next base that I built. So I'll see you there. We are the crazy people. Oh no, no! Okay, no! I got distracted by my own reflection. Ah! Just kidding, not that vain. You're so vain, you probably think the song is about you. Oh my god, what the fuck? Hey guys, we're back and my truck is just doing flips over me. Just one-handed flips. So fly. Yes, I'm Fergie. It's Faggy. It's Faggy. Fergalicious. Alright guys, let's head over to our next base that I built. Looks like I can add one more here. Ah! Hold on, do I have fuel on me? No, I don't have lithium and titanium. And tethers. Tethers are very important. Guys, if you want to play this game, make tethers. Definitely make those tethers. Make tethers. Do it! Just do it! Alright, let's head over to my second base. And away we go! And away we go! And okay, we're not leaving yet. There we go. And away we go! I'll see y'all. Nah, I wanna show y'all this. Ooh, pretty! That's so pretty! Alright, now that we're in orbit, we can choose this little button to see a solar system view of everything that we can go to. Right now we can go to this arid planet and the exotic planet, but right now we need to go to the barren planet, which is the satellite around this planet that I'm on. It's not a moon, it's not the moon, but it's a satellite. Ah, I can see my base from here. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. On this barren satellite, there's not a lot of places to, explore, points of exploration to land on. More than likely, it's due to the sheer, insignificant size of the satellite. But I'm not sure if that's my base or not. I'm pretty sure my base is on the other side. If I'm not mistaken. I might be mistaken. Ah, there it is. I was right. There's a lot of ships down here. Lots and lots of ships, but here is my base. My lunar base. Here we go. Sweet satellite. On this base there's 50-50 sunlight, but the exposure of the sunlight is maybe like 12 minutes, then it's 12 minutes of darkness and then 12 minutes of light. Just due to the sheer, spin of the satellite around the planet. But it's pretty, barren. Just, your five basic four? Hold on. One, two, three. Just your four basic modules. Printer, your research thingy, and then your smelter. Smelter. I like that word. Smelting. Smelter. Smelly, smelly, smur. Smearer. And your bait. Oh, yeah. That's right. Your vehicle dock as well. So I got the four main ones. Yeah. It's pretty barren. Gravity here is way less. As you can see, I can just jump for days. I got bunnies for days. Jump really high. And the jumps on the trucks are crazy. Let me just give you an example of the ramp I can use. Just how high we can go. Just with one. Yeah, lift off. There we go. APR. And I can charge while I'm in midair, so yeah. I can cover a lot of distance just with one jump. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. And the falls, when I fall out of a really high jump, they don't really, I don't get a lot of damage because the gravity is so low, again, that the inertial gravitational pull doesn't harm me when I fall. It's pretty fun when there's no lag. There's tons of lag in this game. It's just tons and tons of laggy. Laggy, saggy, saggy, laggy. Alright, let's head back to the base. Woohoo! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Right on the spaceship. That's pretty awesome. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's nice. Oh my gosh. Oh my darling. I wasn't faced directly like, oh my gosh, I'm on top of it. I've never been on top. Oh, no. Okay. Yeah, to flip the vehicles, all you have to do is press X or tab on the computer, and they'll just keep on flipping for days on this satellite. But on a regular planet, it will cease to flip his wig. Yeah, just like that, and we're good. Alright. But yeah, let's check out the other bases on my other planets. Let's head off. Planets. I don't know what your name is, but I'll call you Sally Sue. Silly Sally Sue, and you'll be Burnett the Barren Planet. Burnett the Barren Planet. Alright, let's go to the... Should we go to the Aries? I think we should go to the exotic one. Alright. Well, when the planet is back in the reachable zone, the little circle of destination, whatever it's called, when that planet gets back in, I'll head on over there and I'll meet you there. Yeah! Oh my god, just get your ass over here! Come on, just get your ass over here. It's not a tumor. It's not. I really like how they did the atmosphere. It's pretty cool. Not really accurate, but pretty neat, I gotta say. And why won't your ass just get over here? Ah! Oh, there's the irradiated one. Let's go to the irradiated planets that we can just slingshot off of them. Hopefully we'll be in range by then. Hello, irradiated. I'm pretty sure I have a base here. Do I? Let's double check to see if our base is here. We'll go to the exotic one first. I'll just show you around what it looks like over there. What it looks like over there. If I'm not mistaken, there's only one place I checked out, and I did not make a base there. I just looked around and saw that, oh, I can't do anything. But cry my eyes out because I can't do anything. Yeah, here is the exotic planet, and there goes all my shit. Cause yeah, the game hates me a lot. Like a lot. Yeah, this is the exotic planet. There's a lot of things that will kill you and kill you dead and myrtleize you if you're not smart about what you do. So, yeah, this planet sucks ass in not the good way. But yeah, let's check out my other base on the arid planets. The arid. Oh no, it's not. Oh, come on. could slingshot off of the... I'm thinking we can slingshot off of the irradiated one if we don't rotate faster. Let's go to the irradiated and head over. Oh, they're aligning. Oh, that's so cool. Come on. It's radiated because it's super close to the sun. Alright, here's just the arid planets. Where are we? Oh, there we go. All the bases over there. Alright, here is the arid planet. This is where my main base operation is currently. There's a lot of minerals and rare elements on just on the surface of the planet alone. And yeah, so let's check out the base. I don't see the base, I don't see the base. I don't see the base. I see a sun. Oh, there's a base. I'm just gonna wing it and just select it. I'm a gambler. I just gamble on if that was the base or not. Just kidding. I don't know. Alright, and here is base 3.0. Ta-da! Ta-da! Here we're able to mine a lot of lithium to make a ton of batteries. There's a ton of titanium. And plenty of the ores like copper and aluminum ore over here. So yeah, that's pretty much, you know, how far I've gotten in the game. Here's my big rig of titanium and lithium. I'm just hoarding it down so that I can sell it later and maybe make a profit when the game gets to its full blessing, its full undulating power. And there's more sandstorms over here. Ah! Sandstorms over here are more common on this planet, and the amount of sunlight per day is about 15-14 minutes long, so I had to make a lot of batteries just to keep my truck running. Do 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 do. Da 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 da. I don't know if you can see this, but I have the 3D printer over here, my smelter over here. I have trading systems that I can trade the lithium and titanium into other products, and then over here I have my vehicle base that I can make more trucks, make more space shuttle ships if I have to, and just add more storage so that I can store a lot more things. Let's head back to base 2.0 and head on over there and check out one more thing. So I'll see you there. Alright guys, we're back and I'm like literally almost out of fuel, but that's okay, we're back, we can refuel real fast, and I can show you one more thing. Hold on. Refuel. Oh, plenty. Okay, cool. Oh, fuck. No! No! Get back here. Awesome. But, oh my god. Thank you. There we go. Alright. Now, I want to show you one more thing. One more doohickey, doodad, doodaddle, thingy my bobber, doodly, doodly, toodly, cooly, nib knob, shib shab, super, super awesome type dilly bobble thingy. If my truck doesn't freaking get stuck! Ah! Nah. God. If this mofo does not stop flipping out. Come on. No. No! Okay, good. Alright. Here. This thing. Right here. This hole. This ass hole. I'm just kidding. It's just a hole. Not an asshole. But this thing. Would you calm down? Could you stop it? Stop. Stop it. Stop. Alright. Now this thing. This is a tunnel to the center of the Earth. That's right. We are tunneling to the center of the Earth to see what the heck is down there. And that's I'm going to leave for the next video. Alright guys, that's all the time I have for this video. Look forward to the next video where we tunnel our way down to the center of the Earth. And I'll catch you in the next one. Have a chimpastic day, King Kong named John, signing out.